fallen in memory. It was November 27, 1973. Work got late as usual. I went to the cardiovascular Thrive building to change. I heard a little noise behind me. I thought it's probably a rat or something. As I continued to change, this scuffle got louder. I convinced myself by saying it's probably one of the other lady colleagues. But suddenly somebody grabbed me from behind. I couldn't see it, who it was. Some light fell on his face. It was him. It was Sohanlal. I despised him. But how could somebody ever be so insane, so satanic, so hateful? I screamed, not knowing it would be my last scream. I fell unconscious. It all became blurred to me. It was all pain. Suddenly, I gained conscious and he was strangling me with a dog chain. I fell unconscious again. The next thing I remember is being pushed to the hospital by some ward boys. And then I was moved to the hospital bed. I have remained there ever since. A very good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
This is the ill fate of Aruna Schomburg. I'm not here to talk about women's rights or of how we should be afraid of men in the society. I'm here to talk about what happened to her after the attack. She was in a vegetative state for all these years till she died at the age of 66 due to pneumonia. During the last few years, she could barely breathe, and her bones were so brittle that if her hands or legs caught each other awkwardly, it would probably break. Why did she have to live so many years? Is it to know that people loved her? Or is it because people were too selfish to even let her go? What? She couldn't even cry. Here is a woman who's barely able to speak, barely able to breathe. She's in pain, but she can't even cry. Would you have wanted to help her? The only solution to this is euthanasia. What is euthanasia? Euthanasia is the act of putting an animal or a person who is in incurable condition to death painlessly. What are the rights of people who are in a vegetative state? When do we say that a person is brain dead? What are the rights of people who take care of such people? These are questions that we need to ponder about. There are two kinds of euthanasia: active euthanasia and passive euthanasia. Active euthanasia is brought about by an act. For example, giving excessive painkillers. Passive euthanasia is brought about by an omission. For example, withholding a particular treatment. There is a very unjustified difference between both of them, since even though it is by an omission, we all know that the end result would be death. Please remember, friends, by not giving a particular treatment, it doesn't make the care for the person any less. Rather, it would be respecting the person's autonomy and giving death with dignity more significance. We all live in a world where we're all given the choice. However, the right to live or not is still not given to us. What if she knew very well that she couldn't dream of a life which would ever be real? Yet she lived. Was it to satisfy the needs of people who wanted her to live, or is it because people were too ashamed to accept that euthanasia might be a reality? What if we could actually allow her to die when she had to? A lot of people have discussed about euthanasia. Some say there might be a cure in future to the palliative disease which is incurable today. But what is the possibility that it might come true? These are things we need to ponder about. Life, we make a lot of choices. But is life itself a choice? Life is not about is about living healthy. And healthy is not the absence of illness. Rather, healthy is a glowing vitality. Thank you.